She was a new patient to my clinic looking for a second opinion. She came to Penn because she had a rare cancer called a sarcoma, and it was found in the back of her leg, right behind her knee. And synovial sarcoma is a soft tissue cancer, so it occurs in the muscles, often around but not inside of a joint. It is quite rare, and it would be quite common for a physician or surgeon not to recognize this if it wasn't their area of practice. Regardless of its rarity, it's still a deadly cancer. So patients die of synovial sarcoma as they do with other sarcomas, unless we are able to treat them, remove the cancer, and prevent the spread of disease to the lungs or other sites of the body. She was told by another cancer center that the only real treatment was to amputate her leg. So she was looking for something different, and I think she was nervous. My approach was to review her story, of course, look at the medical records, review all of her imaging studies, obtain any new tests that we might need, and review it with our team. So she didn't ask what the safe treatment was, she asked what we could do for her to allow her to live the life that she wanted. And she wanted to save her leg. Where the tumor was located was right next to her blood vessels and her nerves that allowed the foot and the rest of her lower leg to work. So removing it wasn't just like popping it out of there. It already was an area that was contaminated by a prior surgery. And we don't really know where the contamination is. We opted for treatment with radiation to try and sterilize the field ahead of time. And then we went in and removed that entire area that looked abnormal on the MRI scan, including her blood vessels and a portion of her nerve. We were able to save a part of her nerve that allowed her foot to pull up so that she did not need to walk with a foot drop brace. But she required a very extensive surgery with expertise from our microvascular and plastic surgery colleagues to be able to reconstruct the blood vessels, to be able to graft her nerve to hopefully get nerve function back in the area that we had to remove, and to cover her with appropriate tissue so that she would heal well. And the radiation and the surgery work seamlessly together to be able to provide the best local control that we can provide. And she actually came back with function. She was actually walking earlier than we would have expected her to walk. And she's just continued that pace on through her recovery. She's now running. She's now working out on a regular basis. She looks fantastic. It's quite remarkable. We can do what we can do at Penn Medicine, but actually the patient is what takes the result to even a higher level.